Hi guys, welcome to Learn English with M to the power of 3. Please join us for today's lesson as we explore and sharpen our English skills with
So I make this wish to have something more for us than this.
In Rosas, a 17-year-old girl named Asha feels something dark about the kingdom's ruler, King Magnifico, that no one else notices it. She makes a passionate plea to the stars in a moment of need, leading her to meet a living magic star which has fallen from the sky. And together, they face off to the kingdom's evil ruler. If you're eager to improve your English, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and join us on this language learning adventure. Don't forget to ring the bell for the latest updates. Let's start. Number 1. Be up to something. Let's watch.
What are you up to?
What makes you think that I'm up to something?
Be up to something. If someone says they are up to something, it means they are currently doing or involved in a particular activity or task. For example, what are you up to means what are you doing right now? Or what are your plans? It's a casual way to ask about someone's current activities or situation. It can also be used when suspecting someone of having secret plans or intentions. For instance, if you say, "I wonder what he's up to," you may be questioning someone's motives or actions. Let's watch some examples.
So Rachel, what are you up to tonight?
Well, I was kind of supposed to be headed for Aruba on my honeymoon, so nothing.
The princess has been training him. They are up to something, sire.
So, what's going on? What are you guys up to?
He's up to something.
What are you guys up to?
Father-in-law, son-in-law bonding.
They want to know what he's up to.
What are you up to, Liddy?
Now let's review that scene.
What are you up to?
What makes you think that I'm up to something?
Number 2. At all costs. Let's watch.
I will protect you at all costs. At all costs.
At all costs. It means doing something no matter what challenges or difficulties may arise. It expresses a strong commitment to achieving a goal, even if it requires significant effort or sacrifice. Let's watch some examples.
We've sworn to protect Arendelle at all costs.
Arendelle has no future until we make this right.
Go back inside. Protect the wallpaper at all costs.
Keep this one alive at all costs.
Keep it from Rachel at all costs.
Keep what I found. Have to at all costs.
Stay away from that woman at all costs, okay? That's Susan's mother. She's bad news.
Now let's review that scene.
I will protect you at all costs. At all costs.
Number 3. Look on or at the bright side. Let's watch.
We should be looking at the bright side. Asha, you got to the final few being considered for the most prestigious position in the kingdom.
Look on or at the bright side. It is an idiomatic expression that means to focus on the positive or optimistic aspects of a situation, especially when facing challenges or difficulties. Let's watch some examples.
Look on the bright side.
What's the bright side?
Only 9 more months to Comic-Con.
What's wrong with looking at the bright side of things?
I guess what I would want to say is to look on the bright side.
Ah, look on the bright side. I mean, at least you won't have to live with this ugly chair. That was here already, huh?
Let's look on the bright side.
Look at the bright side.
Now let's review that scene.
We should be looking at the bright side. Asha, You got to the final few being considered for the most prestigious position in the kingdom.
Number 4, pass down. Let's watch.
What's passed down generationally?
To you.
It's me.
Passed down. It generally means to transfer or give something to someone who comes after you, either in a literal or figurative sense. It could be passing down physical objects, like handing down clothes, or passing on a family tradition or knowledge to the next generation. Let's watch some examples.
His father finally passed down something helpful.
The crown of the conqueror, passed down through generations.
It's tradition for the current sisters to pass down their presents gowns to the new pledges.
A man has a lifetime of experience that he wants to pass down, something to leave behind.
You have a fighting spirit. Passed down by your father, no doubt.
Our memories, they have to be passed down by those who knew us in life.
Now let's review that scene.
What's passed down generationally?
To you.
It's me.
Number 5. Sink in. Let's watch.
This might sink in the morning. We are our own origin story.
Sink in. It means to fully understand or comprehend something, often after some time has passed. Let's watch some examples.
The real effect of October 29th took a little longer to sink in.
After the wedding, the fears began to sink in, take hold.
The magnitude of my task began to sink in.
I suppose some of it sunk in, despite my best intentions.
Just starting to sink in, and I got a problem, a big problem.
How long does it take to think for it to really sink in that I've got it?
Now let's review that scene.
This might sink in the morning. We are our own origin story.
Number 6. Stole someone. Let's watch.
Magnifico could come back at any time.
And that's why you're gonna stall him. Please and thank you, best friend ever.
How am I supposed to stall a king?
Stall someone. It means to intentionally creating obstacles or slowing down a person's efforts, progress, or actions, often to gain an advantage or prevent them from achieving a goal. Let's watch some examples.
Ross, she's gonna start getting ready soon.
Well, can't you at least stall her a little?
Just stall her. I won't let you down.
Stall her!
You're gonna fight an entire army?
No, I'm just gonna stall them.
Delta, stall them. I need more time.
Now let's review that scene.
Magnifico could come back at any time.
And that's why you're gonna stall him. Please and thank you, best friend ever.
How am I supposed to stall a king?
Number 7. Need to vent. Let's watch.
I clean up all your messes and I'm always there when you need to vent.
Need to vent. It means someone wants to express their feelings or frustrations and is looking for someone to listen to them. Let's watch some examples.
Guess I just needed to vent.
I just sometimes need to vent and pace to get stuff out.
Sometimes I just need to vent.
Suddenly feeling the need to vent.
Yeah, like you say in your book, I need to vent out my feelings.
I just needed to vent for a second.
Now let's review that scene.
I clean up all your messes and I'm always there when you need to vent.
Number 8. Play dumb. Notice that B is silent here. Let's watch.
Go, return to your stables. If anyone asks, play dumb.
Play dumb. It means pretending not to know or understand something on purpose. Let's watch some examples.
Jason De Laurentiis has been saying some nasty things about me.
Like what?
Don't play dumb, Hannah. Wouldn't be the first time you made up a story.
Okay, what's this all about?
Don't play dumb. You called me to bounty Mike Wiltz. And funny thing, when I found him, he was dead.
Just use small words so I understand.
Don't play dumb with me. We both know what your problem is.
Running around in that funny little romper of his.
His what?
Rosie, don't play dumb. We've all seen Abe in his little romper. It's hysterical.
Play dumb all you want. You're not getting away with this.
Now let's review that scene.
Go, return to your stables. If anyone asks, play dumb.
Number 9. side with someone. Let's watch.
Do you side with the traitor, Amaya?
No.
Side with someone. It means to support, align, or agree with them in a situation or disagreement. Let's watch some examples.
Are you siding with her over me?
No. Baby, no. I'm siding with us. I just want it to go back to how good it was.
But if he should side with the enemy, a dragon could be used to terrible effect.
He's right. Oh, why can't you side with me just once?
But they sided with her, so I made a tuna salad sandwich and I ran away.
You're siding with him?
Now let's review that scene.
Do you side with the traitor, Amaya?
No.
Number 10. Show your true colors. Let's watch.
Cause now I've seen him show his true colors in shades of green.
Show your true colors. It means revealing your real character or intentions, especially if they are different from what others initially thought. Let's watch some examples.
Time to show your friends your true colors. Tell them all your nasty desires.
Let him show his true colors.
Ronaldo Albizzi has shown his true colors.
See, Batman has shown Gotham your true colors, unfortunately.
He showed your true colors, didn't you?
He showed his true colors.
Now let's review that scene.
Cause now I've seen him show his true colors in shades of green.
Alright, now it's time to practice what we've learned. The quiz has 3 questions and you have 5 seconds to answer each. Let's start. Number 1. What does need to vent mean? A. Seeking assistance for a problem. B. Wanting fresh air. C. Wanting to share feelings or frustrations. Or D. Requiring a cooling system. Well done! The answer is C. So, need to vent means wanting to share feelings or frustrations. Number 2. What is the meaning of pass down in this context?
They pass down wisdom to their children's children.
A. Throw away. B. Forget about. C. Hide. Or D. Hand down. Good job! The correct option is D. Number 3. What is the opposite of side with someone? A. Collaborate with someone. B. Disagree with someone. C. Align with someone. Or D. Agree with someone. Well done! The answer is B. So the opposite of side with someone is disagree with someone. I'm hoping you got all the questions right. If you have any questions or want to share your thoughts, please leave a comment below. Your feedback is incredibly valuable to us. Explore more content on our channel and don't forget to subscribe for future lessons. And please share this video with your friends who are also learning English. Remember, practice makes progress. So keep watching, keep learning, and keep improving your English skills. Interested in continuing your learning? Check out this video to learn more exciting expressions. See you in the next one!